Today on Upfront, labor, jobs, and the economy. Where do unions go after the collective bargaining battle?
Unions provide a balance in our economy, but it's important to have a strong union movement if we want to have a healthy middle class.
Then state lawmakers will soon come back to Madison to tackle jobs and the economy, but what can they really do to create jobs?
We want to create an environment where venture capital can create those jobs, invest in new and growing companies.
And the sector's leading the way for the state's economy.
I think that we're actually positioned better than what you see in a lot of states right now, particularly in the upper Midwest.
It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gouchet.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. It's Labor Day weekend, traditionally a time to celebrate the achievements of the American worker. But is labor here in Wisconsin and in other states at a turning point? Public employee unions in Wisconsin lost their right to collectively bargain for anything more than wages in a battle the entire nation watched earlier this year. So on this Labor Day weekend, we look at labor, its status, and how public employee unions regroup after a bruising battle. We're joined now by Stephanie Bloomingdale, Secretary-Treasurer of the Wisconsin AFL-CIO. Thanks very much for being with us today.
Thank you, Mike.
How would you describe what has happened in the state to organize labor in the last year?
Well, really, it has been unprecedented and historic what has happened over this past year in Wisconsin in terms of organized labor. The response, the fight back from organized labor and working people in response to Scott Walker's unfair and unprecedented attacks on public employee unions has really, I think the word is inspiring. And it really shows us that working people, whether they're in a union or not in a union, say, you know what, Scott Walker, union rights are important, both in the public sector and the private sector. And more importantly, that unions provide a balance in our economy, that it's important to have a strong union movement if we want to have a healthy middle class.
Do you think labor has suffered some people have gone so far to say this is almost a death knell for labor, what has happened in Wisconsin. Do you think that's an exaggeration of where you are right now?
I think that that's what some people want to do, is to erase labor from the landscape and to just have sort of this opportunity for corporations to do whatever they want to increase their profit. And so, again, labor, organized labor, is important to have real balance for a fair economy, where working people can have a fair shot. If they work hard and they play by the rules, they can have a good life for themselves and their kids. And what we're seeing is, I think, a revitalization of organized labor.
You're one of the things you're doing is you've gone to court. The state AFL-CIO has gone to federal court to challenge the collective bargaining legislation. How optimistic are you that you'll get the outcome you're looking for in the courts?
Well, really, we are fighting these attacks on the public sector unions at every level, in the courts. You know, for the recent recall elections, where we did win two additional senators in very Republican districts. And we're also, fighting in the courts, because the right to a union and the right to a voice in the job is something that we believe is a fundamental American right. That the unions, the strong unions, in a fair and a democratic way, is essential to maintaining the real fabric of our American society.
You mentioned recalls. So let's talk about recalls. Does your organization plan to work actively to recall Governor Walker? Has a final decision been made on that?
This has been a real grassroots movement from the very beginning. And whether or not Scott Walker is recalled will be up to the people of Wisconsin.
The head of the national AFL-CIO, Dick Trumka, said they haven't made a determination of whether or not they would invest time and resources in this sort of effort. Wouldn't they really need to be on board before you could pursue something like that?
Well, really, Rich Trumka, president of the AFL-CIO, there are discussions taking place, but really it is really back to the will of the people. And does Scott Walker deserve to be recalled? Well, certainly he does. And I think that people are passionate about these issues. People want to restore fairness. They want to restore a fair democracy. And they want to restore union rights. And when union rights or any kind of rights are taken away, people in Wisconsin don't let that go easily. And people are going to fight back against that until these rights are restored. And I believe that the rights for public employees to have a true and meaningful voice in the workplace will be restored.
On this Labor Day, let's talk about the president for a moment. Are you and our folks in organized labor satisfied with what the president has done to address the job situation in this country? What would you like to hear from him in a speech this week?
Well, we'd like to see bold new moves around creating jobs and economic opportunities for Americans. I mean, people are suffering. People are worried about what the next step is going to be. People are worried about the future for their children, and if for the first time ever people are wondering whether our children are going to have a better life than us. And that puts us in a real critical situation where we need to have bold moves around jobs, and not only just any job, but really family supporting jobs. And we need to return to those kind of jobs, good jobs, to be able to have a healthy middle class, which many people would believe is what America is all about.
So you'd like to see something, a big infrastructure, a works program, something like that from the president?
Well, in order to have a good economy, we need a strong infrastructure. We need strong transportation, and we need strong education. And what Scott Walker has done in terms of taking away so much money out of the educational process is not where we need to go in order to have a better economy. We need more infrastructure. Investment into infrastructure in education and in transportation and throughout Wisconsin and the nation.
Stephanie Bloomingdale, the Secretary Treasurer of the Wisconsin AFL-CIO, thanks very much for your time today.
Thank you.
We appreciate it. And next, it's job one for state lawmakers, growing jobs in Wisconsin. Just how do they plan to do that? Plus, a plan to eliminate auto emissions testing and make Wisconsin a hub for energy-related businesses. That's when Upfront continues.
Upfront with Mike Ushay, brought to you by American Transmission Company. We'll be right back.